I ran a roadhouse 40 years on a trail that led out west. Some stopped to eat, some stopped for soda, others just to rest. One afternoon, a cowboy came in about 15 after 2. He said, "I'm broke, but for a bowl of soup, I'll sing some stories for these folks and you." We had no jukebox, the radio was broke, and hadn't heard a song in more than a week. So I told him if his songs were good, I'd be glad to give him something to eat. He looked familiar, but so do others, so I just let it slide. He went out to his truck and got an old guitar and brought it back inside. He looked around at me and the others as he tightened up the top string. When he was satisfied it was tuned just right, he started to play and sing. He sang about a female blacksmith who nearly killed her mate. Then he spun a tale of a hired gun who helped an outlaw meet his fate. It wasn't long till my wife, Mary Jo, and the customers all gathered round. Then he sang about a famous bull who made peace with a rodeo clown. The whole place roared with laughter when he told us about old Nick and Scratch, a one-eared fella and a one-eyed dog who took a few cattle and met their match. The story of a cowboy saved by a miracle soothed our souls. Mary Jo even cried. It touched our hearts when he sang about the top hand who saved a young boy's life and nearly died. We thought he was telling his own life story when he told us about the drifter who tried to settle down but never quite made it. Then his words painted a picture of the western frontier and all the beauty God created. By the time he finished the story of a magnificent stallion, beads of sweat had formed on his brow. He wiped away the sweat and asked, "How about that bowl of soup now?" As he ate, we talked, and I asked him where he was going and where he'd been. He said, "I've been in my father's footprints, and now, like him, I'm just a troubadour who rides the western wind." He said, "My dad spun many yarns about what he saw in his years of singing and traveling around. But old dad was sure right when he told me this roadhouse had the best bowl of soup he'd ever found." His words hit me like a blacksmith hits an anvil. Instantly I knew his father was the troubadour who traded some songs for a bowl of my soup back in 1922. As he packed up to leave, he turned and smiled and said to us, "Hope you folks have enjoyed these tales of the Western Trail."